You're almost done with the car project. You still need to animate the visibility of the clones. If you need to pick up where we left off in the last movie, you can open the file named car-sim-visibility.max. The idea is to make the clones appear only after the animated car clears them. For the first clone at frame 0, there's nothing to be done. The second clone is a different story. Go ahead and select it. Scrub the animation and note that the animated car matches its position at frame 4. So in fact, this clone, car 002, needs to be invisible up until frame 4 and starts appearing only from frame 5 onward. With the clone selected, right-click and go to the curve editor. Select the car 002 node. From the edit menu in the curve editor window, choose visibility track, add. A new visibility track is added. Go ahead and select it. A visibility track works with values ranging between 0 and 1. 0 means an object is invisible, 1 means it is visible. Anywhere in between creates a fade effect. For the moment, and by default, the visibility track has a constant 1 value, meaning the object is visible at all times. You need to add 2 keyframes to animate the visibility between frames 4 and 5. Use the Add Keys button to add 2 keyframes anywhere on the flat curve. Go back to Move Keys and select the first key you added. Set its position to frame 4 and value to 0. This makes the object invisible up to and including frame 4. Select the second keyframe and set its position to frame 5 and its value to 1. This ensures the object is visible from frame 5 onward. Exit the curve editor and scrub the animation to see the effect. Sure enough, the clone can now only be seen after frame 4 when the animated car matches its position and orientation. Now that you understand the concept, you need to repeat it for every subsequent clone object. Remember to define the moment in time where it needs to switch from invisible to visible, and repeat the procedure you used earlier. For the next clone in line, that would be between frames 8 and 9. For the clone after that, frames 12 and 13, and so on. Keep on adding visibility tracks for the rest of the clones, and when you're done, play back the animation to see the result. A completed scene has also been provided for your convenience. So far, you've used Snapshot to generate direct clones of animated objects. In the next scenario, you learn a technique to generate wavy meshes that represent an object's motion in an artistic way.